Coach Antonio, that ain't plaster, is it?
Nah.
All right. We gotta make sure we.
Nah, just don't tell nobody, all right?
Coach Antonio, you ever catch anybody wrapping hands at an event and be like, wait a minute, that ain't right. What y'all doing? Y'all ain't doing that right.
Yeah.
You've actually caught people trying to.
Nah, so far, no.
Okay.
Nah. What I've seen so far, some of these trainers having some shitty.
Uh-huh.
I've been seeing some of these trainers having some real shitty ass hand wraps on.
Oh, in other words, their hands might break by the time they get down to second, third round.
I seen some rappers where the whole gauze came off.
Should have seen the amateur hand wraps when you're fighting overseas. It's only like three or four swipes and then the whole hand wrap finished. So yeah, we fighting them. So that, like when I just told you that Russian hit me and I feel like, man, this is gonna be knocking me out because the hand wraps, the hand wrap is like real horrible.
So, Coach Antonio, let me ask you, how come sometimes when you see a guy get down to fight and they take off the gloves and they take off the gauze, their knuckles be bleeding or red pretty bad? Is that just bad wrapping that caused knuckles to start bleeding?
You know, it depends if it just comes from the paint of the glove.
Okay.
You know, sometimes that red stain might probably be coming from the glove and everything.
Okay.
Or it might be leaking from the punches and everything.
From just hard punches, or maybe the wrapping wasn't thick enough?
That can be that, or like I said, it might probably be just a stain of the glove.
Stain of the glove.
So you never know. It might, like you say, it might probably be bad hand wrapping.
Right.
Well, a fighter will know when they do a bad hand wrapping on it.
Right. Okay.